My grandfather fought the Japanese here in World War II and never left. Married a local girl. My father was native born and a sergeant major, so I'm second generation military. And from the time I was 10, I wanted to follow in their footsteps. I wanted to be a soldier and protect and defend this country against all enemies. Well, I did my job. Did what I was told. Always followed orders. Until the day they gave me an order I couldn't follow. You see, it's hard to describe how it feels when everything you believe in turns out to be a lie. When the people you trusted let the ones you love die. And none of my commanders were born here. None of them knew the land and the people who lived here. None of them had to sacrifice anything. So they made others sacrifice what was dearest to them. I still can't believe I was the only one to say no, but I was the only one. I was accused of desertion and treason, and for that I was to spend the rest of my life in prison, simply for helping those I'd sworn to protect. Well, now I know who the real enemy is. And this fight is not over. I swore an oath. And as far as I'm concerned, John Morgan is still a soldier.
My name's Perna, and I'm going to tell you about the worst bloody holiday ever. I was at the Royal Palms Resort on Benoit, working as a bodyguard for some asshole CEO. I figured once he left the island, I'd have a good week to relax on the beach, enjoy a Mai Tai or two. But no, that wasn't to be. As I woke up one morning to discover that the goddamn zombie apocalypse had arrived. A local lifeguard by the name of Cinnamon saved my life. Soon after that, I discovered I was immune to whatever this plague was. I met a few others who were immune, and somehow we were all elected to save everybody else. There was Sam B, a one-hit wonder hip-hop star from the States, Logan, an ex-football player and full-time douchebag who never missed a chance to hit on me, and Shin Mei, a sweet little hotel clerk who was as brutal with a blade as anyone I had ever seen. Together, we went to Norsby to try to gather more supplies. And from there, things really went to hell. The army tried to contain the infection, but they were bloody useless. Benoit itself was totally isolated. It was pretty clear we were on our own. At this point, we just wanted off that goddamn island. And that's what led us to that maximum security prison. You see, some dickhead colonel by the name of Ryder White lied to get us to track down what he thought was a cure for this zombie plague. Well, that cure ended up turning White into a giant bloody maniac. Luckily, we hooked up with a prisoner who flew us out of there on the colonel's helicopter. We were off that goddamn island at last. And everyone we tried to save back on Benoit, well, they just didn't make it. Except for that little native girl, Yarima. We spotted that naval vessel just in time, as we were just about out of petrol. We couldn't believe how lucky we were to finally find a safe haven.
Get off me! Get it off! What's with the cuffs?
Sorry, but I can't take any chances. My orders are to take you into custody and transport you to a secure quarantine area.
And who the hell are you?
Lieutenant Colonel Samuel Hardy. Don't resist and you'll be fine. We just need to be sure you don't pose
a threat. Ain't we no threat? The threat's on Benoit. You have any idea what's happening back there?
We have an idea. We're hoping you can help us fill in the details. Especially her.
You keep the hell away from her.
Frank Serpo. I should have guessed. Are you the one in charge of this clusterfuck? Watch yourself with this guy. This freak would sell out his own mother. If he had one.
Take the immune down to the lab. The two others will come with me.
Lab?
Hey, do we look like goddamn guinea pigs to you?
I'm a citizen of the USA, man. I got motherfucking rights.
Back off, Serpo. And just stay out of it.
What the fuck, man?
Don't do that again. One less immune won't make any difference. Now take him to the lab.
You may have command over Palinai, but on this ship, I'm in charge and I have my orders.
Your orders are to follow my orders, Colonel. Would you like me to call your superiors?
Somebody tell me what the fuck is going on here.
They have a very high tolerance, Mr. Serpo. I've already administered 3 doses.
So how much longer? You said we'd have results by now.
Sir, this is uncharted territory. We'll need another day at least.
Just be careful. We don't want them dying on us.
What about the native woman, Yerima?
That's a more complicated case. She's being taken to another location.
Don't worry. I'm keeping a close eye.
God. My head.
What the hell happened? Motherfuckers drugged us.
Who are you?
Hey, we're talking to you.
I'm nobody, really.
You've been bitten. How long has it been?
Long enough. I guess it doesn't affect me.
Are you immune too?
So it seems.
What? They plant you here to spy on us?
Right. That's one beat to shit like this. It's all part of my cover.
So they tested you too?
Yeah. I'm guessing they're trying to figure out why we're all immune to
this.
How'd
you get here?
I was a soldier before the shit hit the fan. Part of a huge humanitarian search and rescue operation. And then that civilian arrived.
Serpo.
Right. Suddenly, the military was no longer in charge, and the rescue operation was called off.
So what are they up to?
All I know is there's a naval blockade around the entire archipelago. No one's allowed in or out. Whatever the fuck is going on, there's nothing to do with humanitarian efforts. That's pretty clear.
Christ, I'm still woozy from these bloody drugs.
Hey, where are the others? Well, they must have taken them when I was out. This is a fucking dog's breakfast.
This is Colonel Hardy. The ship's been compromised. If you're down in the hold, I'm opening all the cell doors.
I better head topside. Get my bearings. Looks like the crew already bailed.
I need to find a weapon. Bastard's still trying to command a dead ship.
This is the captain. If anyone's still alive, fall back to the bridge.
way should be clear.
Whoever took care of that, you deserve accommodation. You just saved a lot of lives.
No.
the upper decks.
Come on, Daddy needs some new shit.
Ah!
a storm to deal with.